always helped me with questions and was kind to me. Sister Rose made First Communion the best.
Sister Rose made everything so much easier.
Sister Rose would help everyone.
Sister Rose, I liked when Sister Rose did the Do Dot store.
I like when Sister Rose always gave me a problem in the Do Dot store.
I like how Sister Rose always gave me hugs.
I like how Sister Rose was always sweet.
I love how Sister Rose was always so positive.
I like how Sister Rose was always kind.
I loved how Sister Rose was always so positive.
I loved how Sister Rose was so nice.
I love how Sister Rose made religion really, really fun.
I like Sister Rose because her smile on her face.
I love Sister Rose because she always let us do the Do Dot store and let us use money whenever.
I love Sister Rose because she was super generous.
I love Sister Rose because I just do.
I love Sister Rose because she was always willing to help me with math.
I love Sister Rose because she helped us with communion.
I love Sister Rose because she was very, very, very kind.
To sit it out or dance, I hope you dance. I hope you dance. I hope you never fear those mountains in the distance. Never settle for the path of least resistance. Living might mean taking chances, but they're worth taking. Loving might be a mistake, but it's worth making. Don't let some helping heart leave you bitter. When you come close to selling out,
When we made crystals and cups that were all kinds of shapes, sizes, and colors, we watched them grow over time. It was really cool.
When we did store and we got to buy candies and toys, and I remember bringing home a ton of things later that day.
When we did store, I remember getting a really cool toy.
Consider, give the heavens above more than just a passing glance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you do.
Wants to look back on their youth and wonder where those years have gone.
I hope you still feel small when you stand beside the ocean. Whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you'll give faith the fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance.
Second grade, you helped me on all my math tests.
When you helped me with my multiplication facts on a test. Thank you.
When we were studying, you gave us gummy bears. Thank you.
When you did fake detentions.
Whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance.
fifth grade and we had buddies. You would always wait for me because my buddy was the last one to pick out a book.
When on the first or second day of school, you left the whole class little stuffed animals on your desk. Thank you.
Sister Rose, one memory that I'd like to share with you is the 1990 eighth grade versus faculty basketball game. Although the game was scheduled for March, we started practicing early January with Coach Jim Carlson. Jim ran us through hard, disciplined, regular practices that included drills on all the basics of basketball and a few sneak plays. By game time, it was apparent that you would be the next John Stockton and the biggest threat to those poor eighth graders. You were making baskets, defending the rim, and running an occasional play. All was well, even more than well, until you came down with the best rebound of your life, and then your knee went out. And well, we know the rest of that story. However, the way that you play basketball is how you've always played the game of life. Go strong, take every shot you get, and get every rebound, even if it might take you down for a short time. You are my hero, and I'm so grateful to God for all the wonderful memories through the years. The next shot you make is a three-pointer for sure. Go with God, my friend.
I have many fond memories of Sister Rose. As a parent, I remember the reading time that we had as a family, and we incorporated that as our after-dinner activity. In fact, my son, Nick, incorporated that into his own family when his boys were in second grade. As a teacher, I realized right in the beginning, you don't challenge Sister Rose to pool, shuffleboard, or playing the slot machine. Only Sister Rose can win $50 on the penny slot machine. Thank you, Sister Rose, for all these wonderful memories.
I remember looking on with admiration as you created such excitement in your students for so many different things, science, hands-on science experiments, geography, as your kids were creating globes out of paper in your classroom, the sacraments, they're getting ready for First Communion and Reconciliation, store. They always seem to have such excitement going on in your room.
I want to just say how wonderful it was to have Sister Rosie at the school and how very much Father Riffle appreciated her. He'd come home and say, I saw Sister Rosie again. And it's wonderful to have a religious at the school as a good example to everybody of what a good Christian religious life can be, how it can be lived, and how important it is to everybody today. Thank you.
Greetings, Sister Rose. I understand that you were retiring at the end of the school year. And I just wanted to congratulate you and thank you for your 30 years of dedication and service to the students, parents, and parishioners of Sacred Heart. In thinking back over the years we worked together at Sacred Heart School, my fondest memory was the way you embraced technology, always keeping in mind my advice that you control the technology because you control the on and off switch. My thoughts and prayers are with you as you begin this next step along life's journey, and then you will enjoy your retirement as much as I am enjoying mine. God bless and enjoy your retirement.
Hey, Sister Rose, I just want to say thank you for all the many years of service that you've given to Sacred Heart School, to the parish. I especially want to thank you on behalf of my children. They turned out pretty good, and I think a lot of it was under your influence, especially Julie, and she wanted me to tell you how much she appreciates you and how much she has always looked up to you as a role model and as a teacher. And now she's teaching in Venezuela and soon to be in Burma, and she hopes that she can be the kind of teacher that you've been. So we all wish you well, and we thank you so much from the bottom of our hearts for everything that you've done.
Do you remember when we first met? I sure do. It was sometime in early September. You were so lazy about it. You made me wait around. I was so crazy about about you I didn't like. I was late for class, I liked my bike to yours. It wasn't hard to find, you painted flowers on it. I guess that I was afraid that if you rolled away, you might not roll back in my direction real soon. I was crazy about you then, and now the craziest thing of all, over 10 years have gone by, and you're still mine. We're locked in time, let's rewind. Do you remember when we first moved in together? The piano took up the living room. You'd play me boogie woogie, I'd play you love songs. You'd say we're playing house, now you still say we are. We built our getaway up in a tree we found. We felt so far away, but we were still in town. Now I remember watching that old tree burn down. I took a picture that I don't like to look at. All these times they come and go, and alone don't seem so long. Over 10 years have gone by.